I'm Jim Schaefer with PowerFlow Tuned Exhaust Systems, and we're here in sunny Florida in Winter Haven joining the Cardinal Flyers organization for their annual get-together pre-sun and fun. We're here with a bunch of beautiful Cardinals. Most of them have the PowerFlow Tuned Exhaust System on it, and we're going to ask a few of our customers who've been flying with the PowerFlow system on their customers, on their airplanes, excuse me, to give you their honest, unbiased opinion. So enjoy the show. Here we go.
I've had it on the engine now for 2 years, and I've had a couple issues, but I can't say enough about PowerFlow's support. As far as any time I've had an issue, I call them and they immediately address it. They immediately jump on it to fix it. Performance-wise, I did a bunch of flight tests with the plane before I put it on and right after, and up to 8,000 feet, I picked up between 8 and 10 knots. Oh. And up to 18,000, it tapered off, so at 18,000 feet, I picked up 3 knots. Uh-huh. The time to climb up to 18,000 feet was a consistent 20% improvement. And since I've had the PowerFlow on the plane, my total fuel consumption, I track my total fuel consumption based on tack hours. Uh-huh. And my total fuel consumption has dropped from 9.8 gallons per hour to 9.2 gallons per hour with the PowerFlow.
Okay.
And I'm flying, you know, 5 to 10 knots faster.
Excellent.
So it pays for itself. It's probably the best investment you can do with your airplane, as far as it'll pay for itself over a few years in fuel savings.
Great.
So, and one other thing I noticed, it dropped the cylinder head temperatures across the board by 25 degrees.
No kidding.
So, I mean, it's a big help all the way around.
Well, actually, this is my second for PowerFlow. I had a Cardinal fixed gear that had a PowerFlow exhaust on it. So when I bought my RG 4 years ago, the first thing I did was order a PowerFlow exhaust. So I had ran it 50 hours without the PowerFlow, put the PowerFlow exhaust on it, got a nice comparison, about a half a gallon, or about 3/10 of a gallon less. It runs better, it's smoother, it's very quiet. About a year ago, I put a IO390 on it, and I put the IO390 on it. My first question was, can I put the PowerFlow exhaust on the 390? And the mechanic said yes, and so off we went, and so now I've got it on the 390, and it actually is quieter on the 390 than it is on the 360, but works great. I love it. I wouldn't have anything else.
Do you have any advice for somebody thinking about getting a PowerFlow for their Cardinal?
Ordered one yesterday.
Okay.
Biggest thing about the PowerFlow that I've noticed is when I first started training customers with the PowerFlow, I really couldn't get a feel for whether it was real or voodoo, because I didn't get a chance to fly the airplane before and after the installation. But as I started doing the training and started flying with a lot of different Cardinals, and those that I knew prior had not had the PowerFlow, especially the earlier models, the 68s, 69s, I started to see a trend where those that showed up with the PowerFlow had more guts. They were, the airplane gave me a little more confidence in being able to do some of the maneuvers where I need to get off the runway quick, and some of the specialized training work that I do. So after roughly 15 years of flying these airplanes, there's no doubt in my mind that whatever condition the engine is in starting out, it's going to be a stronger engine when that unit gets on it. In fact, I tell people about the 68 Cardinal with the original 150 horsepower, that when it's got the PowerFlow on it, I know the aircraft is really going to have the guts to do the job.
Well, I've had two Cardinals. I had a 76 fixed gear, which I had the first generation PowerFlow on, and then I later swapped to the second generation PowerFlow. Now I have a turbo RG, which I can't get a PowerFlow. I wish I could, but it really wouldn't do much good. But my whole thing about PowerFlow is the customer service and the support from the company. I had a small crack in my first generation, the 4-into-1 pipes, and immediately Darren and the team took care of that and fixed it for me. Actually gave me a whole new system. The beauty of that is that I did have the prop balance before and afterwards to show that the engine was not defective or too much vibration, and they honored the warranty and I got a free new system. I think maybe 2 or 3 years after I had bought it originally. And it's all about customer service, taking care of the people. And I believe in the system, fuel savings, a little more speed, but certainly better takeoff roll and better climb out of the thing. It's easy money. It's the best thing you can do for your engine, I think.
Great. I'm Miguel Fernandez. We're here at the CFO convention in Winter Haven, and I just want to say Power Flow, I was a little bit skeptical at the beginning before the mod, you know, but Darren went with me and we checked the plane first, and the before and after comparison is the more buck that you could get out of that mod in terms of knots and how the performance of the engine. I feel a lot less vibration, a lot cooler, and the whole service support from the PowerFlow people is awesome. I only have good things to say about it.
Great. Would you
I believe it? So. I think that certainly in the beginning there were a lot of skeptics, but I think the test data, not only the advertised data, but the test data proves that the engineering was sound. And the product is good, and the warranty service is beyond belief. It's beyond superb.
We have nothing but good things to say about the Power Flow system. Our aircraft, N2657 Victor, was the original STC'd aircraft for the Power Flow, for the Cardinal, that is. We cruise in no wind at altitude 145 knots. I do think it increases the horsepower, the climb rate some, we get more airspeed, and I highly recommend it. It was a great addition to the aircraft, and ours was the first one ever placed in a Cardinal. It's been working great ever since.